Well, good morning all of you. We will see few definitions and today we will be covering arcs and its measurements. Firstly, few of the definitions for arc. First definition, central angle. The central angle is an angle whose vertex is the center of circle. Okay, what does that mean is, if I have a circle of this form, then the angle that is formed at the center, this particular angle is called as the center angle. And the minor arc is an arc with the central angle less than 180 degrees. Okay, here this particular arc that you see is the minor arc with the central angle. This particular arc is less than 180 degrees, which we can make out. Okay, so this is going to be called as the minor arc. And the major arc is an arc with the central angle which is more than 180 degrees. So for the same central angle, this major arc is going to be this particular arc which is greater than 180 degrees. Okay, I'd like you all to note out all these three definitions: central angle, minor arc and major arc. And then we will see few properties and problems based on them. Okay, I'll give you like a minute or so to note. Okay, before we move on to the next slide, just see there is one more definition. A semicircle is an arc whose end points are at the end points of the diameter. Okay, semicircle. So if I have a circle and if this is by diameter, then the one which I am marking in red is a semicircle. The other one which is left in green is also a semicircle. Semicircle is an arc whose end points are the end points of diameter. Okay, let's move on to next slide after having seen what is minor arc, major arc, central angle and semicircle. I hope these definitions are clear to you. We will see measuring arcs in this particular slide. The measure of minor arc is the measure of its central angle. We sometimes say the angle subtends or intercepts the arc. Okay, for example, here the below figure which we have, this arc AB subtends a central angle of 50 degrees. That's what we say. Okay, and this is our minor arc. The measure of major arc is a measure of central reflex angle. The reflex angle is the angle which is greater than 180 degrees, or the difference between 360 degrees at the measure of the related minor arc. Here the minor arc is 50 degrees and the major arc AB is going to be 360 minus 50 degrees, which is 310 degrees. And this is how we denote a minor and major arc. Usually we use two letters and an arc is drawn above. So this particular arc indicates a minor arc, and ADB is, you go from A and you reach D and then go to B. So this is your ADB. You usually use three letters to indicate minor arc and we draw the arc above. So the measure of the minor arc AB is 50 degree in this figure, and the major arc is 360 minus 50, which is 310 degrees. Okay. The measure of the major arc is measure of the central reflex angle. Let's see few problems based on that, but before I give you a chance to work, let me do this particular problem. Name the major arcs and minor arcs at semicircles in this particular figure. Okay, so let's list few. You don't have to, we will try to list as many as possible, but something is left out, you may just try to add them. Few of the minor arcs that come to our mind is here. So first one is RM. RM is the minor arc. I'm just listing all my minor arcs in red first. Then I have MN as the minor arc. Then I have arc NP, which is other minor arc. we have PQ, which is the other minor arc, and we have QR. We definitely know that even RP is going to be smaller than 180, so if you want, you can also list PR. And if you want further, even here, not just LP, you can also list NQ. Okay. These are our minor arcs. Before we get the measurements of these minor arcs, let's try to write the corresponding major arcs. So RM was over here. Corresponding to that, we have a major arc on the other side, which is RPM. So you go from R, go towards P. R is over here. You go towards P and then reach M. So the major arc, we use three letters. So let me use different color here. So for RM we have R, P, N. Same way, instead of for MN, I can either say NQM or MQN. So let me just write MQN as the major arc here, the reflex side. Then same before NP. NP I can have INRP. NRP as the major arc. Then corresponding to PQ, I have PMQ as the major arc, or I can also take QMP. Let me take PMQ. PMQ as the major arc. And same way, corresponding to QR, I have the major arc as QNR. QNR. Before we see the, let's finish up those as well. Then we have PR and NQ. For PR, we can take PNR. Okay. PNR. So PNR is same as RNP, or even we can say the other letter also. It just doesn't have only one single name. We can call PNR, or you can say PMR. Both are same. RPNR, RPMR, both are same. Same way, it's also same as RMP or RNP. Okay, the last one which is there is NQ. NQ is nothing but NRQ. I'll just use NRQ. Okay, let's try to get the values of each of these minor and major arc. Just observe here, we have RM, arc RM. We need to find RM. This angle is 81 degrees and this is 73 degrees. Let's find this missing angle, which is angle POQ first. Angle POQ is 180 minus 81 minus 73. 180 minus 81 minus 73 gives us 26 degrees. So this angle is 2060. Angle QOR is vertical to angle MON. So this angle is 73. And angle MOR and MON are supplementary. You can get that 180 by the 73 gives us the angle MOR, which is 107 degrees. This is still a minor arc. The RM, the arc RM is 107 degrees, and the value is less than 360. The value is less than 360, and it's less than 180 as well. If it's less than 180, then it is minor arc. So angle arc RM is a minor arc. So if you do 360 minus 107. Gives us a major arc. So in this case, RPM is 253 degrees. same way, arg mn, which we already have, which is 73, and major arc mqn is 360 minus 73, that gives us 287. Okay, let me use an egg because here angles are in. 287. Let's see NP. We have NP as 81 degrees, which is a minor arc. To get major arc, you do 360 minus 81, that gives us 279 degrees. So I'm just writing towards this side, 279 degrees as your major arc and arc. PQ. PQ was given to us, we found that as 26. And corresponding to it, the major RPMQ, which is 360 minus 26, that gives us 334. 334 degrees. And QR, minor RQR, is 73 degrees. And corresponding to it, the major RQNR is 360 minus 73, which gives us 287. Let's see further. PR. P is over here and R is here. PR is 73 plus 26, which is nothing but 99 degrees. And 360 minus 99 is nothing but 261, which is our major R corresponding to PR, that's PNR. And NQ. NQ is 81 plus 26, that is 107 degrees. And corresponding to it, the major R is 360 minus 107. Which is nothing but 253 degrees. I hope you have understood how to find major minor arcs in a when the central angles are given. Okay. Let's see the next slide. We will see a few postulates based on these arcs. The arc addition postulate. The measure of an arc formed by two adjacent arcs is the sum of the measures of two arcs. Okay, here this arc AB plus arc BC gives us arc ABC. That's what they say. Here arc AB plus BC gives us arc ABC, which is nothing but the arc which is there in red combined with the blue. Okay, arc ABC is the red and blue together. Okay, it's like your addition postulate. When you add two lines, you get the line which the addition postulate for the line segment. When you add two line segments, you get the sum of those two line segments. Same way here, when you add two arcs and they're in the same circle, you get the larger arc formed by those two arcs. Let's see the next slide. Find the measures of the unlabeled arcs. Okay, they are asking us the measurement of the unlabeled arcs in each of these problems. Okay, I would like you all to think and get the answer. I'm just going to label this 1 and 2. Take like a couple of minutes for each of them, then I'll go over the solution. Okay, you have like 2 minutes for each of them. Please don't overthink, they have given just single arc here. So this is a single arc, they have given single arc in each of them, which means this particular arc QPS is congruent to arc QS is congruent to arc RS. So therefore we can say if this arc is X and this arc also will be X. So 2X plus 52 will be equal to 360, and you can further simplify and get the value of x. So 360 minus 52 will give us 3.8, and divided by 2 gives us x as 154. So here RQS equals 154, and same way arc RS is also 154 degrees. If you want, this second problem is exactly similar. They have given single arc here, single arc here. Don't get confused thinking that these two are not congruent. When they indicate by one arc line, which means these two angles are congruent. Therefore, the central angles for arc JK and arc JL are same. So arc JK is congruent to arc JL. Once again, you can call them as x and x and simplify as 2x plus 74 equals 360. So 360 minus 74 is 286, dividing by 2, I get x as 143. So you'll have arc JK equals, measure of arc JK equals 143 degrees, and same way measure of arc JL is also 143 degrees. Okay, let's see further now. I'll give you some more time to work on the problems which are there below. Just try this for a couple of minutes, then we will go over the solution for each of them. They are asking us to find the values of x and y. Okay, take a couple of minutes for each of them. Okay, let's do problem number 3. We know that arc DG is 180. Arc DG is 180. Arc DG is made up of the angles 2x degrees plus 90 degrees because of arc EF and arc FG, which is x. But before writing this step, if you want to write the previous step using the arc addition postulate, you can write arc DG as arc DE. Arc DG is nothing but arc DE plus arc EF plus arc FG. This is your arc addition postulate. Instead of arc DG, I can say it in this way. I can also say that arc DG equals DJ plus JH plus HG. That we will use for Y, but let's first finish up with X. DE was 2X, EF was 90, and FG was X equals 180. 2x plus x is 3x, 3x plus 90 equals 180. Subtract 90 from both sides to get 3x equals 90. Then dividing by 3 on both sides, I get x equals 30. Same way for this part, same problem, problem number 3. I can also say that DG is, arc DG is also equal to arc DJ plus JH plus HG. DJ plus JH plus HG. DJ was, arc DG is already, we know it's 180, let me use different color. Arc DG is 180, let's write first this as 180. 180 equals DJ is Y, HJ was also Y. We know HG is congruent to DE, arc DE. Arc HG and DE are vertical angles, so HG and arc DE both will be 2x. So I can just substitute hg as 2x. Further simplify this, 180 equals 2y plus 2x. Dividing by 2, I will have 90 equals x plus y, or y plus x, dividing by 2 on both sides. 90 equals y plus x. And I have already the value of x as 30. So subtracting 30 from both sides, I found already x as 30, so substitute here. 90 equals y plus 30, subtracting 30 from both sides, I'll get y equals 60. That's for the first one. This is clear. We use arc addition postulate for this problem. Same way for this particular problem, I will have 5x plus 7x minus 12. Both of these will form 180 degrees. Okay, 5x plus 7x minus 12. 5x plus 7x is nothing but 12x minus 12 equals 180. Divide all throughout by 12. So first divide all throughout by 12. That gives us 15 equals x minus 1. Then add 1 on both sides to get x equals 16. So in this case, I get x equals 16. And this problem did not have the value of y to be found, so you just have to find value of x and we are good. Okay. I hope these two problems are clear based on arc addition postulate. Okay. Let's go on to the next slide. RT and PS are diameters of circle N. Find the measure of the given arc if arc TP is 47 degrees. Okay, I want all of you to try this particular problem. Then I will go over the solution in exactly 2 minutes. Please try this particular problem. Okay, let's try this particular problem. They have given us RT and PS are the diameters at circle N is given. This is a circle N, so this point should be N. Okay, based on whatever is given, TP is 47, I just tried to, first I drew RT and based on that I just took a PS in this manner so that I can get 47 degrees somewhere close to that. So if this is 47 degrees, I know ST is going to be 180 minus 47. 180 because of arc addition postulate, arc ST plus TP should be 180. And we already have TP as 47, so 180 minus 47 is nothing but 133. So arc ST is 133 degrees. Same way, PR, arc PR and PT are going to form 180 degrees. Arc RP plus arc PT is 180. So 180 minus 47 once again will give us this as 133 degrees. Okay, now they are asking us to get the value of RTP. RTP is nothing but the reflex angle of PR, that is 360 minus 133, that gives us 227 degrees. That is 360 minus 133 of PR. STR is the reflex angle of RS. And arc RS, this is nothing but 360 minus arc RS. RS is equal to TP because they are vertical. Let's see that RS and TP are verticals. 360 minus 47. If you do 360 minus 47, that will give us 313 as the required answer. I hope these kind of problems are clear to get the arc measurements after having constructed. Let's see the next. Okay. Congruent circles and arcs. Two circles are congruent if they have congruent radii. Okay. If The two circles are said to be congruent if they have the length of the measures of their radius should be same, then we can say that those two circles are congruent. Two arcs are congruent if they have the same measure, that is the central angle, that at central angle of those two arcs should measure the same. Okay, two arcs are congruent if they have the same measure and they are the arcs of either the same circle or congruent circle. So two things have to be satisfied when two arcs are to be congruent. First of all, they have to have the same central angle measure and they should be arcs of the same circle or the congruent circle. So two things have to be satisfied for arcs to be congruent. First thing is they should have same measure, which means the central angle should be same, and they should be part of the same circle or congruent circle. They are asking if AB and CD are congruent in each of these. Let's see. AB and CD are congruent for each of these. So here AB and CD, if they have to be congruent, then they should be part of the this is definitely a no, because though the angle measures are same, the radii are not same. They have not given that the radii of these two circles are same. We don't know whether these two circles are congruent, so therefore we can't say no. This can be either a no or this can be a yes. The first one depends on the radii, but it looks like both of them have same radii. If both of them have same radii and if these two circles that are drawn are congruent, then yes, we can say that arc AB and arc CD are congruent. Let's see here. This is the same circle and arc AB is 63. Let's get the value of CD. CD is going to be 180 minus 54 minus 63. This is also a 63 degrees. So therefore, yes, arc AB and C, this is 100% yes. This one depends on the radii. We don't know whether radii are same, but if their radii are same, then we can say yes, this one 100% too. Okay, you can utilize rest of the class time to complete the unit 8 test. We will continue from here in our next class. Okay, hope you have a wonderful week.